Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to show you a very simple workflow for setting up the reflection of your caustics water effect. So the heart of this video is going to be setting up the reflection and how to do that quickly. We're talking 30 seconds tops, okay? This is the hardest part as outlined by Mike Miller in his video, Caustics and Creating the Water Effect, that he did for the HitFilm YouTube channel. And I will leave a link in the description below as well as a card right here. You can go look at that. That video outlines every single little detail that you will need to know when it comes to creating a water effect. Every last little thing is covered in that video. What this video will do is show you how to set up the reflections quickly and easily, like I said, in about 30 seconds. Okay. All of these videos that I have showed here, I've done about 12 of them. Each of them only took about 30 seconds to set up the reflection. So I am going to start by creating a new composite shot, and it will only be 10 seconds long. And this is just setting up. I'm going to call this one the picture, and I am setting the picture up in its own composite shot. The reason that I am doing that is so that way, later on, if I decide, man, I really would like to, maybe add, a sun flare or add a Death Star, right, or add some birds flying across, then they'll automatically be updated in the main shot. Okay, so having said that, I'm going to create a new composite shot. This will be the water map. And again, this is all just setup stuff. I'm going to create a new plane, and that plane I will add the fractal noise to, and this is all covered in much greater and better detail than I am doing in the video that Mike did for HitFilm. I am going to cheat and use a preset of watery, which I'm not sure, but Mike did his tutorial in HitFilm 4. Version 4, and I believe maybe this wasn't in that, but now it is, so we can use it. I am keyframing the seed, so that way that watery look changes over the 10 seconds, right? That's going to create the waves that we're going to use, and this will be the map that we end up using for our water effects. So now I'm going to create a new composite shot. This will be the final shot. And clicking OK, I'm going to drag my picture in, and I'm going to drag my water map in. I can hide the water map. Now, in Mike's video, he added a plane layer and just laid it over the top. What I am going to do is I'm just going to mask out the skyline. This will work, especially if you have a jagged skyline like in this shot or like in this shot, a skyline that isn't a perfect line, okay? I'm going to mask this out. I'm going to do it fairly quickly. And here we go. Let me see. But I would suggest that you be as detailed as you possibly can. So now that we've removed the water or the part that where the plane is going to be, I will add a new camera. And then I will add a new plane. I'll just drag in one of my one that I already have. Make it 3D. I'm going to rotate it to be 90 degrees. And then if I grab the control, I can drag it on down here and just make it big enough that it is going to cover the whole area. I don't want it to be too big, but on the other hand, I don't want it to be too close to being near the center line. So negative 170 is good. 300 is good. Okay, that's not terrible. We just want to make sure that it's not too close to the camera and it's not too big because that'll distort the wave effect. Okay, so now that we've set up our three-dimensional water plane, and that is the water plane, so let me go ahead and rename that. I can add the secret sauce of this effect, which is the caustics, and bring it in here. And then if I open up the caustics, under the environmental map, I can go ahead and choose the picture, and poof, there it is. So now you're saying, all right, how do you set this up to be a perfect reflection of this? Well, here is the heart of this tutorial, all right? What has to happen if I open up the transform properties? What has to happen is you have to fiddle with a texture scale, the texture ratio, and then the X, Y, and Z rotation numbers, okay? Until this is a perfect reflection. The problem is this could take a long time. I mean, it could take 15 minutes, could take a half an hour, could take an hour, right? It could take days, you know? I mean, it's so difficult to get this. So I have developed a system that I use, and I used on a dozen different shots here, as I'm sort of showing them to you, and each one of them I did all exactly the same. So here it is. I'm going to set the Y rotation to 180 degrees. I'm going to set the Z rotation to 180 degrees, okay? From here, I am going to drag the X rotation to the right into the positive until I can see the shoreline, and the shoreline's about there. Then I'm going to drag the texture scale to the left, shrinking it down. If I have to, I can adjust the rotation again, but I want these mountains here to be the same height as these mountains here. In other words, I want this to be exactly the same height as this. So I'm just going to keep dragging it down until it's pretty close, adjusting the rotation as well, and that's pretty close. Then when I get to there, you can see that the reflection happens here and over here. I'm going to drag the texture ratio until they are about the same, okay? I can make a few more adjustments as necessary. I probably will have to physically, kind of find the numbers. You can see that cloud is a little bit taller than that one, so I might go down to, say there and drag this out. I'm getting pretty close though, right? Basically, I want these to be exactly even with each other, okay? When I am happy with that, and, I'm pretty close right here. Let's call this good, okay? When I am happy with that, then I can go ahead and go back to the height map and source the water, maybe slide this down to 2 or 3, and that's it, okay? So one more time as a review, I'm going to set the Y rotation to 180, the Z rotation to 180, then I'm going to drag the X rotation until I can find the horizon line, then I'll drag the texture scale down, and then the texture ratio up until it is lined up the way I want it to be. So if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to watch the original tutorial by Mike on the HitFilm channel. I will leave a link also in the end card. And hey, thanks for watching.